Hello, I'm Hille Suojalehto and I will go through a few main points of a new review article on occupational mite allergy and asthma that was produced by EAACI task force. High prevalence of mite sensitization has been detected among workers in agricultural and food processing occupations. Mites are also present in workplaces where people congregate and are active. In addition to house dust mites, storage mites, spider mites, and predatory mites, which are used in biological pest control, are found in workplaces. It is good to keep in mind that grouping according to occurrence of mites is not consistent with taxonomical classification. Occupational risk factors for mite allergy include exposure to high levels of mite allergens, prolonged duration or repeated exposure, high humidity and poor ventilation of workplaces, individuals with atopy or pre-existing sensitization to mites, and tropomyosins or other cross-reactive allergens may have an increased risk. Climate change is likely to change mite populations, mite growth and survival, as well as the proportion and frequency of the produced proteins may change. Occupational rhinitis and asthma are the main clinical manifestations. The diagnosis is challenging because commercial extracts for skin prick tests and specific IgE measurements and individual allergens are not available for many species that are detected in workplaces. Also, cross-reactivity between different species has been demonstrated. Early diagnosis and removal or reduction of exposure are essential in prevention. Several measures are available to reduce allergen levels at workplaces, and regular medical surveillance is recommended for high-risk workers. I would like to thank all the task force members for preparing this review, and thank you for listening.